from the soul with it. What's going on, everybody? Dialorex TV back with another video, and I would like to discuss with you guys an article that I've read pertaining to Los Angeles Lakers being willing to potentially trade just about every single player on the roster. This article is via Inquisitor and also through Tania Ganguly with the Los Angeles Times, and the headline reads, LA Lakers willing to listen to offers for any player except LeBron James and Anthony Davis. And the article goes on to say that though the Los Angeles Lakers hold the best record in the Western Conference, rumors are circulating that the team is planning to be active on the trade market before the February NBA trade deadline. With the emergence of numerous title contenders in the league, it makes a lot of sense for the Lakers to continue to find ways in upgrading their roster. According to Tania Ganguly of the Los Angeles Times, a source who is familiar with the Lakers' thinking revealed that general manager Rob Pelinka has expressed a willingness to listen to trade offers for any player on their team except LeBron James and Anthony Davis. So if you guys would like to read the entire article, the link is in a description box. So it's quite hilarious to me when I make a video addressing the Lakers weaknesses and areas that I think that they need to improve on, and just me being a realist, it's actually quite ironic how I just recently put out a video, actually the last video that I just did, on how the Clippers are more active and are in a better position ahead of the trade deadline. So I then highlighted the Lakers weaknesses and their weak spots, and just being a realist about how the Clippers defense looks better than ours, whether it's the regular season or not. We can say, oh well, they can sweep us 4 times in the regular season and it won't matter because they won't be able to defeat us in the playoffs. But this article is clearly a counter to your argument, because it confirms my sentiment that if we expect to defeat the Clippers with this current roster that we have now, meanwhile the Clippers with their elite defense, the elite defensive team that they have over there, they're looking to position themselves and get better than what they already are. I was just stating the obvious. The Lakers need to work twice as hard before the trade deadline. We can't just sit back and say, oh well, we're the Lakers, we have a 36-year-old LeBron and we're going to the finals, which I still think we're going to the finals, but we need to improve. You know, I had a subscriber go as far as to tell me that I sounded like I was scared of the Clippers, right? And I'm like, I'm not out there playing, so what do I need to be scared for? Okay, so does this article prove that the Lakers front office is scared? Because now that it's being revealed that everybody on the roster basically is available, being as though that the Lakers are 30-7 and they have the best record and the number one seed in the Western Conference. And it's also funny because I stated this a few weeks ago that I thought that no player on the roster is safe. See, you can't fool me. I'm not into smoke and mirrors. You know, we went on a 4-game losing streak and we lost to 4 championship caliber elite teams who are going to raise their level of intensity on defense in the second half of the season and seek to destroy in the playoffs. And I agree with you. You know, I believe that the Lakers will make some moves as well, but, and I have the license and the freedom of speech, you know, to be able to critique. I'm not going to sit up here and tell you what you want to hear. I'm going to tell you what you need to hear, okay? We need to get better defensively. If we want to win a championship, we need to get better defensively, because defense wins championships, period. Like, the Lakers front office, they here, they know what's going on, okay? So they better get it right, because I love my Lakers and we can look like world beaters and look unstoppable versus subpar caliber teams, but teams like the Clippers and all these other elite teams like the Bucks and, you know, other Western Conference teams, they're going to be looking to snatch the hearts out of the Lakers' chest, and we need to be looking to do the same. And I'm gonna end this by saying this. Y'all say AD not going nowhere, he's not leaving and blah blah blah, right? You don't know what's going on in this man's head right now. You don't know how he feels. He may really want to go back home. Once he has a 40-point or 50-point night, right, he scored like 40-50 points, right, in a game. And, or you know how the media always tries to attach LeBron James to Anthony Davis, and they say LeBron and AD combine for a certain amount of points. And if we keep this roster for the remaining of the season and AD gets the blame once we lose, then guess what? Anthony Davis has the option to walk away this summer. The free agency pool is very slim next season. Then we're left with nothing, okay, but LeBron James. And then the media will destroy the Lakers because they're pro LeBron James, because he's their marketing asset, and that will hurt our reputation. You could say, oh, it doesn't matter if the Clippers just win one title, it still won't catch ours and blah blah blah. Listen, they don't need to win any titles, okay, because it all starts with them winning one title and creating a culture, and other players will then want to go there, and the Lakers dynasty could become something of the past. Once again, I'm not saying it's going to happen, but if you're not cautious, it can't happen. It's like owning a company, right? I'm gonna just say this, and I promise you I'm gonna end it after this. It's like owning a company, and say like a taxi cab company, right? A taxi cab business, and you're not evolving. You don't improve your company. You don't move with the times, and you don't advance like technology. You don't advance with the technology and things like that. You have high prices. Then a small company like a Uber, like a Lyft comes along and have a cheaper cost and better quality. Then as you look around and you'll see that the whole world would rather take Uber than to take a cab. It's like what you're saying with the New York Knicks and the Brooklyn Nets. The Knicks have become a great team of the past. The Nets signed two top free agents this past summer, and the only reason the Lakers got lucky is because Anthony Davis was traded here. Like, we cannot forget that top free agents didn't want to sign with the Lakers this past summer. Just like the Clippers and the Lakers, that could possibly happen. Like I said, I'm not saying it's going to happen, but it can happen if we don't get better, and they could come for the throne. So we must go all out right now. Jerry West said everything has a cycle. When he joined the Lakers years ago, many years ago, the Lakers weren't even relevant at the time when he joined the Lakers, and they weren't as popular at the time, and all the other teams that were in Los Angeles were. And he stated things come full circle, and we cannot let that happen.